So there are, well, your instructor is trying to be helpful here on the on sort of this middle area where he's kind of saying, well, this is what you're looking for. This list here is actually it conveys two things. It conveys like what you're looking for, and then in some cases how to do it. I think what you want to like, there's only one absolute value here. All the rest are, I mean, I would maybe say like this is x squareds, these are x squareds. These are linear, the systems, x squareds, and linear. So there's only one that's going to be absolute value.
And it's going to have those like two bracket bars, whatever they're
Yeah,
called.
two vertical bars, yeah. So the way you solve an absolute value is you isolate the absolute value. And that's why it says to use inverse operations. It's because you're supposed to sort of treat it like 2x plus 2 equals 4, where the x is the absolute value.
Oh, okay. So I'm supposed to make it like multiply it.
You're supposed to visual like not write this, but visualize it like this, that you need to undo the two that's adding, and then divide by two because it's multiplying.
Wait, so what do I do with that minus one?
There is not okay. So the big X, this big X here is meant to represent all of this,
Oh,
like
okay.
mental, like mental math kind of thing. But
All right.
to do your problem here, let me actually do your problem correctly. I still haven't quite figured out how to get this point across with students. Yeah, so you're not even supposed to look at this absolute value. You're just like it's there, but you want to undo plus two by subtracting two.
All right. And then that would give you equals two,
Yes.
and then divide it by two.
Divided by two. So you have absolute value x minus one equals one. And this is what results in two equations.
So then that would be like plus minus.
Yeah, you end up saying exactly the way it's written, and then the opposite sign.
All right. And then you'd add one and then subtract one. So then that
No,
would be.
you add one in both cases.
Right. I don't know why I said that.
Maybe you wrote the right thing, but you
Yeah.
gotta say the right thing too.
Then, so like, I understand the absolute value, like that one, like I'm. Can piece that one out pretty much every time. It's pretty hard to mess up.
Yeah, like you want to get that one. Now let's look at number three. And I'll grab that list again to try to help here. Cuz the things like there's probably some things here I'm going to notice that are going to be more useful. This one only has x terms. Only has terms with x.
And then I guess they do technically have three in it too, right?
Yeah, but everything has an X in it is what
All
I'm
right.
trying
Everything.
to it, now you could maybe argue with me and say, okay, well, what about the zero? And then I would say, well, zero times X is still X, or still it zero X, okay, is the way we can write it.
Yeah,
But
I got it.
why did I write this only has terms with X or only has X terms? Because that is when you use this factoring approach.
All right.
Now, your instructor says this here for ax squared plus bx missing c. That is true. It's also, I don't know, very mathy. like, you know, room full of math teachers, math educators would be like, yeah, I agree. But for students, I don't think that's very, very helpful. I think it's better to say like they have to all have an X in it.
All right. All have X.
And that's, yeah.
And then, all right, I guess for the solving of it, how would I start the first step of that?
You have to factor out the greatest common factor.
Factor our greatest common factor. So I guess 3x.
Yep. That gives you x plus 2 inside parentheses.
X plus 2, and then you'd...
And it's a little awkward because the zero is on the left. You can actually write it where the zero now is on the right.
All right.
You can always move or switch sides. That's totally okay.
So then you could... All right. So, I mean, I guess... Do you just write x plus 2 equals 0 and then subtract the 2?
You actually set them both equal to zero.
Oh, okay. Oh, right. Yeah, that's the part that I just get a little messed up on. So then you'd divide that one by 3 and then subtract that other one by 2.
Yes.
All right. X equals 0, x equals negative 2. Okay. Yes, I don't know. I'm just like, it's just those little steps like that is just what I'm like messed up on. It's like once it's done, I like all of it like unlocks in my memory. But
yeah, it, yeah, I just put together an article for final exams and try to focus on the stuff you don't know.
Yeah.
It does you no good to continue working on things that you already do.
Yeah.
So if you truly understand absolute value, like don't spend more time studying on it. Just move to the stuff that you
focus on, that stuff you don't
get. Yeah, which is hard because you like doing the things that work.
Yeah, you like to feel good about it. All right. Well, I think on this one you have to make all the denominators 6. So that would become 2x plus 18. Equals minus 15x plus 6x minus 12.
I'm sorry, say that one more time.
You just make all the denominators 6, so then it would be like 2x.
Well, you multiply everything by the common denominator. But before we do that, like let's go back because this is what you're asking me. I think this is really important. We gotta notice something about this problem here. And you're already doing it, but this is a clearing the fractions because there are fractions. But you probably saw me earlier to this one's linear, meaning there's no x squareds.
All right. Oh, true. There's no x squareds at all in that.
Now let me just scroll up just a tiny bit here to that first kind of venture through this. There's really two types of problems you're going to see, squareds and linear. And that's kind of your first like fork when you're deciding what to do. Because You can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 square methods. And then absolute value is kind of in between, but there's 3 linears and then an absolute value. Like that's how you've got to train yourself to look at these problems. Like it's one or the other. So this problem is linear. It's linear because it's x to the power 1, x to the power 1, x to the power 1.
X to the power 1, x to the power 1. All right. Clearing the fractions. Okay. Oh, and then it does also say eliminate the denominators.
Yeah. Now we're going to do exactly what you said, but we got to find the least common multiple of 3 and 2, which is the common denominator, which is 6. And this is very important. You multiply everything by 6, every term. Now, I'm trying to indicate what the terms are so that you can see what they are. There's, you know, sometimes it's like, well, what do I multiply? And you have to know that it's the terms.
All right. And then with this one makes quite a bit of sense to me.
Yeah. So this is 2x plus 18 equals minus 15x plus 6x minus 12.
Yeah.
And often these do not actually result in a nice, friendly, normal number. They end up, being, something else here. So add 9x. So we'll subtract 18.
So we get 11x equals negative 30x equals minus 30 over 11.
Yeah.
All right. I guess that one makes a little bit more sense to me too, since it says clearing the fractions, and that's like the only one with fractions.
Yes, you're always, it's going to definitely have fractions if you're going to clear the fractions. That's what you're looking for that type. Okay, so here's our next problem. Let me grab this list here. What I want you to notice right away is that this is a quadratic. And that means that it's not that one. It's not that one.
It's not that one.
So it's one of these. And actually, it's missing equal zero, which is weird that they would even give that.
All right. So, wait. So this is the one where you have to make the six like 2 and 3, or 1 and 5, or 1 and 6.
So it's factoring, guess, and check. And maybe you see that. I don't really have a good like this is true, but this is the what to do. It's not the why. It's this. I do this with students that learn this for first time. It's multiply to 6, add to 5.
All right, that's how I like to do it.
So you write all the possible pairs, and then you can literally add them all up until you get the one that works. The only way this method fails is if you don't choose the right ones or you don't add them correctly. But you can see that it's 2 and 3.
All right. 1 and 3. I mean, it's 2 and 3. I don't know why I'm saying that. So then with that, so it's like x plus 2, x plus 3. Do you do the thing where it's like x squared plus 3x, or?
That's going backwards. You want to set each of these equal to 0, just like we did. Let me go back and show you, because you already did this. See how we set each of these equal to 0?
Right.
3x and x plus 2.
Most of the time, if it equals 0, then we're going to make like both of them equal to 0.
Yes.
Okay. And then that'd be x equals negative 2 and x equals negative 3.
Yes.
All right. Factor and guess and check. Guess and check, I'll look at it, like trying to remember, is like, oh, the guessing part to this is that you have to figure out what the two numbers are to make the other, or to figure out what the middle is.
I'm looking at your page here, and I don't. Let's see. Looking for question 5 now. Looks like it's. I've got to go look for it. There's question 5. Okay. Found it. All right, so here is question 5. And let me grab that list again. So the list here, like first thing I notice is now there's two equations, which is different. There's only two that can be two equations. Those are systems.
All right, systems equals two equations.
They're also both linear, which is that first sort of like, is it an x squared? Is it linear? That's another kind of like way to differentiate between this. But when I see two equations, that's a system. So which one is it? Well, we got to talk now about substitution and elimination. So you generally use substitution when a variable is already solved for.
Uh-huh.
So like when you look at these two equations, in either equation is a variable already solved for.
Only the top one does.
So like, here's what that means. It means y equals x equals.
Oh, okay. No, they don't have that.
I'm looking at the second one and I think I see this one.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Okay. And maybe that's what is unclear, is like it literally has a variable by itself.
Yeah.
By itself. It's alone. Okay. Isolated.
So when you have it.
Well, they both actually could, but in this case, probably just one. So now what you do is you take, let me rewrite this because it or graphics, because it's got a lot going on here. You take this 5 minus 2y, make this a little bigger, take this 5 minus 2y and you plug it in for x in the other equation. So 4 parentheses 5 minus 2y plus y equals 1.
So then that would be 20 minus 8y plus y equals 1. And then you'd subtract 20, which would then be negative 7y equals negative 19. And then y would be negative 19 over 7.
It ends up being positive. I am shocked that this is the type of answer, because it's fractions and it's messy, but it looks right actually the way you did it. So we'll say it's okay. So now we got to find x. So x is 5 minus 2y.
Uh-huh.
So you take this y value and you plug it in
to the 2y.
Yeah, 5 minus 2 times 19 over 7.
So then would that just become negative 38 over 14, or it'd stay as 7?
2 is 2 over 1. So you multiply the tops, you multiply the bottoms.
All right. 5 minus 38, 7. And then I guess
5 is really 35. Well, so let me write it differently.
So that would be minus 3/7, right?
Yes. And then it's really 35 over 7. Yeah, minus 3/7.
Okay. All right, yeah, that one, I remember that one.
Okay, so when you look at 6, one of the biggest differences between 5 and 6 is that in 6, no variable is solved for. Let's see if I can get that snipped in here.
Yeah, that's all good.
There it is. Like this problem, there's no x equals, there's no y equals. And that's when you use substitution.
And that's because you can easily solve this by, like, there's the x's and the y's are right next to each other. So
yeah, now when it's in this form right here, this is when you use elimination. And that means choosing the variable to eliminate.
All right. So the other one is subtraction. This one is elimination.
The other one's substitution. You said subtraction. Substitution. Probably meant substitution.
Yeah, that's what I meant. So with the substitution, you're doing that because when you're plugging it in. But on this
exactly. One, exactly. That was what we did in the previous problem.
And so then now, when it's eliminated. Because you're like picking which one, you're like, all right, I'm going to make sure I get rid of that one by either addition or subtraction, make it go.
That's
away.
Right. That's right. Now, if you just add these, nothing gets eliminated as is. And you can see that like 3x plus x or minus x doesn't go away. Y minus 2y or plus doesn't go away. So you look for opposite signs. Okay, do you see that these are opposite in signs?
I do. There's like,
okay, so that's where we know, okay, we're gonna eliminate by multiplying the first equation by 2. Because we're gonna get
2y.
2y. Which is gonna give us what we want. So now, like, this is our new, what I've boxed in, this is our new system that we care about.
So then that would just be 7x equals 7, x equals 1. I plug in that 1 probably exactly to the top 1. So then that would be 3 plus y equals 1. And then I just subtract that 3, and then y equals negative 2.
Yes, that's perfect.
All right, cool. It's like I know most of the, I know all this stuff. It's just like getting those names all pieced together.
Yes. Okay. So let's look at 7. 7 is something very different. I gotta go grab that list here. So hopefully you see right away that this is a quadratic of some sort.
Yeah.
Okay, because there's a squared. So it's not that one. It's not that one. It's not that one. It's not that one. Okay. Now, how many X's do you see?
I see one X.
That's right. So when you only see one X, this is the one.
All right.
And it's actually most similar to the absolute value solving because you need to isolate the like this thing. I don't know what to call it, but it's the thing that's squared, the squared term. Yeah,
the like squared parentheses.
Exactly. Squared parentheses. That's the one. So to do that, let me just copy this down. You're gonna undo subtraction by 18. So you're gonna add 18.
And then you're gonna have to divide it by 2.
Yes, and this is where it gets slightly different from the absolute values because now you have to use the square root property.
Yeah, I understand. I actually kind of like doing this one. It's sort of fun. Okay. So once you use that square root value, that would become x minus 1 equals 3. Or ball plus.
Well, there's 2. Yeah, it's plus or minus 3. There's 2.
And then you just have to, subtract that. Add that 1 into the negative 3 and the positive 3, and you'll get your answers.
But you have two equations here. Like you have x minus 1 equals 3, x minus 1 equals minus 3.
Uh-huh. So then that would just be x equals 4, x equals negative 2.
Yes.
And then, yeah, that's pretty much it for that one. And then that one is, what's the name of that one again?
Let's go back up and look. Let's extract the square root because there's only one x.
Because there is only one x. Okay. Because there is only one x. Okay. All right. I like that.
Okay. Let's look at 8. 8 here. We've already done 8, type 8, but we might as well see if you can figure out which one it is. Let me go grab that list.
All right.
All right.
What app do you use for that?
For snipping?
Yeah.
Are you on a PC or a Mac?
I'm just on a like Chromebook right now.
Oh, well, third option. it's a snipping tool that's built into Windows. I am sure the Android store has an equivalent one. You can actually use there's a print screen on your keyboard there, but the snipper really helps you know, to just grab the ones that we really only need.
Oh, cool.
Yeah,
I'm like saving up to like build a PC actually, so
it's kind of cool. Fantastic. It's a lot of fun to do that.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. All right, so this is a quadratic, even though it's not x squared, it's y squared.
Mm-hmm.
That means that it is not clearing the fractions. It is not substitution. It is not absolute value. It is not system.
Okay. And it's not.
So which one is it? Well, and then you could further say, well, there's more than one variable, yeah. So it's not extract square.
Could be yes, check. And then there's also.
It is if two numbers that multiply to minus 24 add to negative 2. So that's where you come in. You got to really be confident that you can figure out those two numbers.
So like negative 6 and positive 4.
Yeah, and that's a good one because that adds up to negative 2. So you already have it. So it becomes y minus 6, y plus 4 equals 0.
All right. I mean, I guess is there when the factors of C come into B, that won't work? Yes, it does. What am I talking about?
Well, that works, but that's what you're doing. That's not how to identify it.
Yeah.
That's what I was trying to explain. Like this list, it's like when do you hit a forehand versus how to hit a forehand?
Yeah.
Like they're different. They're different. I mean, you don't want to be thinking about how to hit it when you're hitting it. You just want to identify, I'm going to hit one, and then you hit it.
I like that analogy.
You know, when do you hit a forehand? When do you hit a backhand? When do you hit a drop shot? When do you hit one over the person's head? You know, whatever,
mm-hmm.
whatever scenario you got, that's what this is. But there's certain techniques that we're trying to, they're kind of incorporated in here. So you have to set each of these equal to 0.
And then you'll just add the 6, subtract the 4.
You got it.
I guess what's another strategy you could use for that?
So the ones that always work is quadratic formula, uh-huh. completing the square. And that would be it. So those always work. Quadratic formula, complete and square always work. Common factoring often, I'm sorry. Factoring, guess and check doesn't always work.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that one just depends.
Yeah.
So we haven't actually done the quadratic formula yet, right?
No.
Would you mind showing me an example of that, please?
Sure. We're going to use it for question 9.
Oh, okay. Awesome. I'll do it then.
And it works out nicely. So it's a good kind of introduction to it. Yeah. Okay. So one minor modification I'm making here is I'm just going to write this as x squared plus 7x plus 10 equals 0. I think this is a great strategy, especially if you don't like the other variables, is to just go to something you do like.
Uh-huh.
The quadratic formula is based on the coefficients of each term. And it has this form, opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So what is a, what is b, and what is c?
A is 1.
Yep. Because it's in this form. AX squared plus BX
All right, I kind of remember this. And then B7, C is 10.
Perfect.
And then, oh, right, and then you plug it into that. So then that would
Yes.
be minus 7 plus minus 7 squared minus 4 times 1 times 10 over 2 times 1.
Yes. And then you simplify this as possible. In this case, you can simplify it all the way, but
Okay, that's this one's called shoot, sorry,
quadratic
what's this one
formula.
called again?
Quadratic formula.
Quadratic formula. All right, my bad. All right. Okay, yeah, I like this one. This one's fun.
You're the
Yes.
first student ever to say
Oh,
that.
really? It was
Yeah,
really
well,
long to
I
learn, and
mean,
then once I learned it, I was like, all right, I kind of like this one.
yeah, maybe you find it has good utility because you see like, oh, it always works. I can always
Yeah,
use this.
I like that one. All
So
right,
the
yes,
key
yeah, so I guess
the key
that.
is to evaluate what's inside the root here,
Yes, yeah, so it would be like 49 minus 40. So then that's
which is
just
nine. So minus 7 plus or minus the square root of 9 over
over
2.
two.
And what's
Then that's
nice is that 9 is a perfect square. So it's minus 7 plus or minus
3
3 over
over
2,
two. And
which is,
that's,
but it's really two things. It's minus
yeah.
7 plus 3 over 2, minus 7 minus 3 over 2.
And then that would be minus 2 and minus 5.
Yes.
All right. Yeah, I don't know. I forgot that one. I like that
Yeah.
all right. So then, I guess that leaves us with one left, right?
We haven't done 10 or 11. There's other pages here also. Where do you want, what direction do you want to go here? Do you want me to give you more problems like we've been doing? Just keep going through the worksheet. There's some inequality stuff we have not done at all.
Let's do some inequality stuff, get that going, because I think that I could use pretty good notes.
Let's start with a pretty basic one, which is a linear inequality, and then we'll move to a more difficult problem set. So the first time you see these in a classroom, what teachers sometimes tell you to do is to treat it just like it's an equal to problem. Like instead of that, just treat it as an equal to. That works in the beginning, but after you do a few, you get comfortable with this symbol. You just write it each time. The only time, though, the only time that you switch this, you switch, and this has to be very clear going into the exam, you switch when you multiply or divide by a negative.
So it has to be by negative.
Yes. If you add something or subtract something, that doesn't change it.
Okay.
Only when you multiply or divide by a negative.
Right. Only when you multiply or divide by a negative.
Right. So, in terms of solving this, I'm just going to rewrite it here. We want to undo this plus 3 first. So, we're going to subtract 3. Did you multiply or divide by a negative right here?
Yes.
Or did I? You did? I did.
No,
I thought I
really
subtracted 3.
sorry,
No.
you subtracted.
So
I got
this stays the same. And that's what's got to be key is if you multiply or divide by a negative, that's when you change it, not when you add or subtract.
you add or subtract. Okay.
Now this minus 3/4 is in front of an X. How do you undo multiplication?
You have to divide it.
Yes, and this is correct, but we're not going to do this because it's awkward. This is option one. Option two is to multiply by the reciprocal.
Okay. Multiply, divide by the reciprocal. So then that just becomes x.
Becomes x, but then this is a very important question. Did you multiply or divide by negative? Yes.
Because there's that negative there. So then that becomes minus, then if it's 2/1, and then you have to multiply by 3. Sorry, am I overthinking that or something?
Yeah, I mean, it's 2/1, so you multiply 2 times 4. We're talking about the right side, is that correct?
Yeah.
Because the left side's always 1.
8/-3.
Yeah, it is 8/-3, but you just move the minus up because it's preference to put it in the top.
Okay. All right, I was thinking I had to make the denominator for the 2/3 also, and then it would be like 24/3, and then it would become like 8. And
yeah. Okay, so you want to try one here on your own?
Yeah.
All right, so let's go negative 5 halves x plus 6 less than or equal to 10. So go ahead and try solving that, please.
All right. Okay, so I have a question. So if it's -2/5 and I bring it over, that's positive. So the sign, the arrow stays the same direction.
Did you first subtract by 6 on both sides?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have -5/2x less than or equal to 4.
Yeah.
Now you could divide by -5/2, but I suggested multiplying by the reciprocal.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Okay, now did you multiply or divide by a negative here? Is that what we're doing?
You did.
So that flips it.
Okay. X is greater than or less than 8/5.
It's
minus 8/5.
It's a binary situation. It's like, is the light on or is the light off? And there is no middle ground. You either are multiplying by a negative or dividing by a negative. Or you're not. There is no in between.
Okay. So if the sign changes, there's a negative.
Yes.
Okay.
Would you like to do another one like this?
Sure, I'll do another one.
Okay. I'll change this up a little bit. Okay, this one's slightly different. It's just a test if you're comfortable with these types of problems. So give this a try, please.
All right. Okay. So with this, it's minus x is greater than or less to -9.
Greater than or equal to.
Greater than or equal to.
Yes. All right.
That's what that line means.
That's what this symbol means. Yes. Okay. Now,
that means what
do you do?
You can't have the negative. So would you multiply / divide both sides by a negative? Making the sign switch, making it x is less than or equal to +9.
Yes, perfect.
Okay. All right. I think I got that. It switches whenever there's a negative, and then you can use it kind of as common sense by looking at it on a
graph. Yes, that was good here. Let me, we don't really have enough time to go into anything new. So let me have you look at a system here. This is question 11, but let's just look at this system here. And if you go back to the possibilities here, there were two types of systems. There was systems substitution.
And then there was
systems elimination.
And this one would be elimination.
I agree. Now, neither of these are opposite in sign. Like X is positive and positive, Y is negative and negative. So you don't have one that's like standing out as like, this is the preferred variable to eliminate. So in this case, I would probably, go ahead.
Oh, wait, would you like,
I want to hear what you have to say, because this is more important.
All right. Would you put like,
what do you have to say on this?
What if I just made like multiplied the bottom row all by negative, making it like minus X plus 2Y equals minus 3.
That's perfect. Minus X plus 2Y equals minus 3. Now, I was going to multiply the top by negative, but it's the same. You end up getting the exact same answer. Now we can add them.
And then that would just be y equals 0.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Then you go back to the first one and you say, okay, well, x minus 0 equals 3. So x equals
3. And it's just nice and simple.
Yes.
All right. Okay, cool.
And we've got time here. So let's look at this was already given. There's a repetition here. Okay, let me have you solve this equation. I got to set it equal to 0. So let me set it equal to 0.
Sounds good.
All right.
So go then ahead. Subtract.
What's the first step here?
Subtract four. And then we just rewrite all of it with a negative 4 instead of 0, and then divide by negative 2. And then x plus 1 equals 2. And then you can't square root this.
No, what you're thinking of is something like this. That then you would square root it because it's absolute value.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So then you make it x plus 1 equals 2, x plus 1 equals negative 2. Right? Yep.
X plus 1 equals 2, x plus 1 equals negative 2. Perfect.
And then that would just be x equals 1 and x equals negative 3.
Perfect.
All right.
Any short verbal questions we can go through?
I guess for Monday, I'd want to like maybe just work a bit on like the graphs, I guess.
Like that's true. We did not spend any time graphing. So game plan for Monday, you want to do some graphing. Okay.
All right. Yeah. But like, the second someone tells me the first step to it, it's like, and then I'm like the rest of it clicks. So I just need to just kind of get that memory down for it. And I don't think that'll be too hard. And then with this, I guess I could just basically use this, make a couple of flashcards and be good.
Yeah, absolutely. What can you do? I guess I would, do you have a math class tomorrow?
Unfortunately, I do not.
Okay.
It's my day off.
I was going to just say it, maybe look back at your old, do you have any of your old exams?
I think I might have one or two, but I'm not positive if it relates to this, but I can check right now.
Okay. So that would be something to look at. Try to look at your notes for anything that was really emphasized by the instructor.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, and come ready, because you know it is a limited amount of time. So just let's not spend time on things that aren't that you already know. Just yeah. Tell me, Matthew. I already know that. Just can we move on to something else?
All right.
It won't hurt my feelings if you say no. Let's move on to something else.
All right. Of course.
Okay. Well, that's kind of it for tonight. I think you got a lot out of this lesson. I mean, we did a lot of problems, and yeah. I think you're going to be in good shape. You're doing great planning for this, and I think you'll see the benefits here, whenever you get your final grade.
All right, I'm glad to hear it.
Okay, well, thank you, Zach. I will send you the notes and the screen recording here shortly, and I'll see you on Monday.
All right, see you, Matthew. Thank you.
Have a good night. You're welcome. Bye now.